Wow, I tell you, I wouldn't have missed this for anything, because Stevie meant a lot to me, but to come out here and be introduced with those words by Studs Terkel, I can die happy now. It's pretty nice. Well, you know, I guess a lot of people, I get the feeling, you know, I've been listening to the show backstage, and I almost get the feeling that that a lot of you people either knew Steve or felt you knew him, that he was like family. And he affected people that way. Maybe you think you know a lot about Steve, but there's one thing about him that maybe not a whole lot of people know, that for one gig, he was the lead guitar player for my hot band. We were playing in Park City, Utah. This was quite a few years ago, and my guitar player had missed his plane. He was coming in from Denver, and actually, the plane had left early, as my guitar player told me. But anyway, he missed the plane. He missed the plane. And so Steve was on the bill and, you know, volunteered his services, which we readily, we didn't know, we said, hey, what the hell? You know, and so it was with just a combination of his incredible energy and fearlessness, good humor, and his enormous heart that it was just a great show because of Steve Goodman, and it's a show I'll always remember, and a wonderful memory that I have of Steve. But I want to go back and do a song of his that, this is probably the over 50 disease, because I can't remember exactly the first time that I heard Steve Goodman, but it was one of the first times that I heard him. He was in a little club in Washington, D.C. called the Cellar Door, and I was just knocking around, you know, trying to remember that place. You know, just trying to make a living and figure out what to do, hungry for music. And heard this song of Steve Goodman's and became a fan for life. It's been a long time since I've seen you. Tell me how you been. Did you ever get to buy that yellow coat? The flowers in the window box still smile when you walk in. Did you ever read the letters that I wrote? I've been on the road since Christmas, but it don't seem that long. Outside of that, there's nothing much to say. Yeah, I quit all that drinking and I wrote another song. I wish you wouldn't look at me that way. To be some mornings we'd go walking in the park, nights we babysit for Billy's kids, and all the times we used to talk of having one ourselves. I don't remember why we never did. Do the neighbors still complain when the music gets too loud? Is that old cat still sleep up on the bed? Sunday you still walk around with your head in the clouds. Have you heard a single word I've said? Well, it's a two-day drive to New York. Guess I better go. Then you notice that the weather's getting cold. Since I saw you last, tell me how you've been. Did you ever get to buy that yellow coat?